Let's tear down chubbyshorts.com. Chubbies, they sell shorts and other apparel. They are one of my favorite brands, my go-to brands for inspiration, and I have spent quite a bit with them on my summer apparel and even a few sweatshirts. So I love Chubbies. So they do some really incredibly smart things on their website that I wanted to show you, and maybe some things that aren't so smart that we should talk about. So when you land on their homepage, the very first thing you see, the way this layout's set up, is this big hero image. And you always, on your hero images, you want your headlines to be easy to read. And I like that, you know, I could click anywhere on the image and it's going to take me straight through. And they've picked these lifestyle images that are very representative of the brand. So that's the first thing you notice when you land on the site. I like that. The other things I've noticed is that there's a lot of sticky elements. They've got this sticky header. If I scroll, it stays there. There's this promo in the upper right that's running and appears to be covering up the cart. And they've got live chat in the bottom right. And then another promo sticky in this bottom footer. Oh, no. Okay. The danger with a lot of sticky elements, especially on mobile, is they eat up so much of the viewport that it can make a messy look. It can make it hard to navigate the site. Now, this is an extenuating circumstance because they're running a promotion. Naturally, they want to promote it. So they've got that sticky element in the bottom and the top right. But just something to be aware of is you've got, you know, a lot of Shopify stores can accrue a lot of widgets on their site. The other thing I notice on the left side is they've got this atypical layout. So most stores would have the menu across the top in the header. They have it on the side. And then it opens and closes in this menu. Very few sites do things like this. Now, clearly this works for them. It's a very successful business. But you want to be careful with reinventing the wheel. You want to make sure that when people land on the site, if you've got new elements that they may have never encountered before or things that aren't where people expect, that can create confusion. Now here, you know, they use a lot of white space and they've devoted this main menu entirely to shopping. Okay, that's the takeaway here. That's the thing you should do. Your main menu, whether it's on the side or in the header, should be exclusively linked to collections and products. Other stuff, other nonsense, that should go in a secondary menu. And here they've done that. So you see they've got the second menu that's much smaller, much less in your face than this big menu. And there's two collections every store should consider or probably include, and it's sale and new. And here they've got sale, and again, that's that promo they're running, and then they've got new. For new stuff, but that's also helpful for returning customers to have that as well. And typically you do, like, I like to have new as the first one and sale as the last one, or reverse that, but you'll find if you have a new and a sale collection link in your main menu, that'll often be the first thing people click on. And the advantage to that is we found over and over, the faster you can get someone to browse the site, they are much more likely to buy. And that's because that's the difference between walking past your storefront and walking into it. So on this, the other thing that's nice here, they don't use a carousel. They just have a series of items. So if they wanted to, they could run three of these identical things. Like, look at these identical images. Those seem familiar. These are like slides, but that's how they're presenting it instead of doing the traditional carousel slider where no one sees it. What I also like is the hero image is very short. It doesn't take up the whole page. So when I see the second image half cut off, that immediately indicates to me as the user, oh, I could scroll and there's more down here, right? So they have done some atypical but very clever things on this page. Let's see. So I want to shop this sale. You know, I've got some chubby stuff. I want some more stuff. Let's see what we got here. Let's shop their sale. Oh, and it's a drop-down menu that doesn't just take me straight to an item. Here, let's click this guy up here on the right. Ah, this takes me straight to the collection. Very good. And what I like about this collection page is I have filters. So especially for apparel, I could click size and then choose large. Because you see they got a lot of different sizes here. I don't necessarily want to see the stuff that's out of stock in my size. That makes for a very frustrating experience for users. When we've done customer surveys and studies, if they find it's a big turnoff. If you ask people, why didn't you buy it? It's like, well, I saw this thing, this shirt, I liked it, but it wasn't in my size or it wasn't in the color I wanted. And then instead of browsing for something else, they just bounce. So having a way to only see what's available to me is a brilliant experience. Scrolling through here, on desktop, they could do this cool thing where when you hover over the image, it shows the second image, the second product photo. That's great. A lot of themes support that out of the box. So you can enable that with one checkbox in your theme settings in most out-of-the-sandbox themes. And then as you scroll down, they've got the availability right here. Okay, I've not seen a theme support that out of the box, but that's a pretty easy customization to make. A developer can do that for you pretty quickly. That's a nice one that I would consider if I was mainly in apparel. Look at all these images. They're so consistent and nice, and they're all square and the same size. On a collection page, you want that really nice, consistent grid. And the trick to it is you have to crop every image to the same size. A lot of people struggle with this. The simplest way to do it is crop them square. And that's what they've done here. You've got these nice square images, which I like a lot. The other advanced thing they've done that you rarely see in a Shopify store is subcollections. So Shopify just has the concept of a collection, which is equivalent to a category, but they don't have the concept of a subcategory. So it requires a custom template, and out of the sandbox themes like Turbo or Flex support this out of the box, but I have almost never seen anyone utilize it. So like here, I'm in the sale collection. You could see the name from the URL. It's a collection called Final Sale. And as I scroll through it, I'm actually looking at a series of collections. So the first one is casual shorts. And then as I scroll, 7-inch shorts and 5-inch shorts. And that lets them group all these products together nicely, which I think is smart. Like, I'm guessing this is the collection description, perhaps? I don't know. But if you're in and out of the sandbox theme, Google your theme name plus subcollections, and you could find out how to do this. All right. So let's pick a product. These are too boring. I am a wild man. I need something crazy. Oh, and I like squids. Oh, my gosh. All right, let's check this one out. Let's click through on this one. Once I get onto the product page, wow. So for the styles, they have chosen to upload custom color swatches. Pretty much every theme these days will support that. And then they've got me selecting my size. All right, here's an optimization they may have missed out on. So most themes by default in Shopify will default to the first size, the first thing in a variant. So here it's size small, usually is. And let's say in the previous page, I filtered by size large. So I know this is available in large. I click through, and then without thinking, I click add to cart. I just bought the wrong size. So now I've got to go through return and exchange process, which as a customer, it's annoying. Chubbies probably loses the profit on the order from having to deal with that. It's not fun for anybody. So the solution, common theme customization we make is on this, when the theme detects variant selection with size, force a selection to be made. So it has nothing selected. And when you click add to cart, it says, oh, you got to select a size. We pop open a message that says that. Or you can change the label on the cart and have it say it. So I know I'm a size large, but maybe I'm not. I better click the size guide. Woo! And it's a modal window. I love having a pop-up, quick, easy pop-up for sizing that shows me the exact size. And look at this. They did something really smart here in the size guide. They have info about what happens if I buy the wrong size. They tell me what the return policy, return and exchange policy is. That's very clever. And they use a modal window, so I don't leave this page. So rather than link to a new page, they keep me right on this product page. Scrolling down, they offer financing using Afterpay. All right, Afterpay is good. I personally prefer Sezzle, but I'm biased. And what we have found is average order value for these financing apps goes way up. It's quite a bit higher in most stores when customers use financing. And we split tested the presence of the Sezzle widget on a product detail page. And the pages that had it converted better. And the reason is the language that these widgets use. So these shorts are $60. Oh my gosh. But down here it says, or four interest-free installments of $15. Well, that's impressive framing. That immediately breaks my brain where I see $15. That's now what I'm thinking about. It makes the product seem cheaper. The other really cool thing they have on here is the estimated delivery date. they tell me, this is when we think this is going to arrive. And we inspected Element on this. It uses JavaScript to calculate it. And it even knows that, like, next Monday was a holiday. It had that in there. It knew. So there are apps to do this. A developer can make a custom widget for you for this. Or if you request it, I can actually give you the Liquid code for a Shopify theme. I've already written it. That will do a similar thing. And then you just swap out your dates and your languages. It's pretty cool. And then they go into like an explanation of features and benefits and then other products that are in the collection. Cool. What happens when we add it to cart? This is the best part. This is by far the thing you should be paying attention to is what happens next. I click add to cart. Cool animation. My cart opens. It's a drawer cart. I think drawer cart's the new default. We should all use drawer cart. But the layout in their drawer cart and the upsells in their drawer cart are best in class, just truly exceptional. So at the bottom of the cart, you can't miss that checkout button because they've got this cool animation on it. If you Google CSS animations, you can find examples of this and add it to your own buttons. Then below that, they've got their express checkout buttons. Oh, awesome. They've made it so easy to get to checkout and buy. If I wanted to optimize this a bit more, maybe the checkout button could also appear at the top of the page as well. But the real magic is in this widget system they've built with these in-cart upsells. So it gives, I've already spent $60 with them, and then it says free gifts, and it shows me what I'm missing out on. So if I spend $99, I get this hat. Oh, well, that's pretty cool. I like that hat. Matches my shorts. Or I could just add this drink umbrella, which the drink umbrella cost them a penny. But it's cool. I can add that to cart. Bam. Now I've got the drink umbrella in here. How neat is that? So building something like this, this complicated, this is entirely custom. It's cool. But you could do similar things with a little bit of customization. Or there are apps that will let you do in-cart upsells. Not quite as involved as this, but you could still do it. And it's just a great way to increase average order value and improve the experience, make the brand fun. The other clever thing in this checkout button is, look, it's got that lock icon. So it already is implying to my brain, oh, well, it's secure. It's a secure checkout without explicitly saying that. All right, let's click checkout and see what happens here. Did they style their checkout? Oh my gosh, of course they did. They're Chubbies. Of course they styled their checkout. So they're using, we could safely assume they're a Shopify Plus customer. And Shopify Plus customers can modify their checkout more than a standard merchant. But what they've done here is standard stuff. They added their logo and they added a header image and they set their colors. And that's it. That's all they had to do to make this checkout match. But I bring that up because so few people style their checkout. You'll be surprised at the big brands that forget to style their checkout. And then I could see, that system added my drink umbrella to the cart. And then it looks like they're using Shopify scripts to do this because I didn't have to add a coupon code, but it still shows me it's a $4 item normally. So that way, if I find this item in their catalog, if I really wanted to, I could spend $4 on their drink umbrellas. And then they have it marked as free gift. It's the Shopify scripts message. It sticks in there. And it shows me my savings and that it's free. Very cool. I love this site for their branding. I love their emails. But if I had to pick a single amazing element out of it that is like just best in class at any Shopify store, it's that drawer cart. It is so good. The team should be very proud. Anyway, check it out. I think you'll enjoy it. It's fun. Hopefully you'll be impressed. And comment below with what other stores you'd like to see me do a website teardown on.